The life of a scientist is as glamorous as you might imagine. Each day is filled with crazy new inventions, world-changing discoveries, conferences at five-star holiday destinations, and spending over 4 hours picking the colour scheme for your dataset. One video game that gets this version of the scientific method correct is Portal, released by Valve in 2007. This puzzle platforming game is often referred to by critics as one of the greatest video games ever made because of its humour and unique gameplay. Portal is a relatively simple and minimalistic game, but one that took advantage of Source Engine's physics capabilities to implement a highly satisfying mechanic. It also had many things that would be well received by players that are now ingrained into popular culture. So let's explore how Portal is true to science with its narrative and approach to physics-based puzzles. But beware of spoilers for the game from here on out.
Learning are the primary goals of all enrichment center activities.
Portal begins with you awakening in a glass box, where you are greeted by an AI voice that informs you that you will be subject to some tests. After a minute-long countdown, you are then presented with the titular portals that form the basis of the gameplay.
The portal will open in 3, 2, 1.
The genius of Portal is that it takes the time to slowly introduce mechanics to you without a formal tutorial. Instead, the early test chambers introduce new concepts, such as the cubes that you place on some buttons that open the door to the level's exit.
Please place the weighted storage cube on the 1500 megawatt Aperture Science heavy duty super colliding super button.
The pace at which you are given the ability to move the portals is also controlled. At first, it's simply a case of using the ones placed for you, before getting access to placing only the blue one, and then about halfway through, you also get the orange one.
Very good. You are now in possession of the Aperture Science handheld portal device. With it, you can create your own portals. These intradimensional gates have proven to be completely safe. The device, however, has not.
You are also gradually introduced to the hazards in the game, such as the floor that will kill you, as well as powering objects by redirecting energy balls.
While safety is one of many enrichment center goals, the Aperture Science high energy pellet seen to the left of the chamber can and has caused permanent disabilities, such as vaporization. Please be careful.
There is also an entire level supposedly designed for military androids, and the turrets that shoot at the player on site serve as an introduction to them appearing later on.
Well done, android. The Enrichment Center once again reminds you that Android Hell is a real place where you will be sent at the first sign of defiance.
In the later test chambers, you are then given puzzles which require you to use all the different things you have learnt up to that point. This is much like how students are taught in real life, particularly as you need to combine different skills to solve them. The game also teaches you about concepts in physics, such as the conservation of momentum that is transferred through the portal. Or as GLaDOS explains it,
in layman's terms, speedy thing goes in, speedy thing comes out.
Another puzzle solution also involves using the concept of freefall acceleration. Here you use gravity to gain speed before entering a portal on the floor where the vertical velocity transfers to horizontal velocity, propelling you across the room.
Spectacular. You appear to understand how a portal affects forward momentum, or to be more precise, how it does not.
Subtle hints are also given to the player where a wall above them may move, indicating that they should probably place a portal there. The result is that teaching you these various mechanics then prepares you for the endgame levels. Genetic Lifeform and Disk Operating System, or GLaDOS, is Aperture Science's artificial intelligence computer system and the game's antagonist. While initially they guide you through the test chambers with quirky dialogue, they eventually try to incinerate you.
What are you doing? Stop it. Hi. We are pleased that you made it through the final challenge where we pretended we were going to murder you.
Inspired by the many murderous AI commonly portrayed in science fiction media, you have a showdown against GLaDOS in a boss fight at the end of the game.
Well, you found me. Congratulations. Was it worth it? Because despite your violent behavior, the only thing you've managed to break so far is my heart. Maybe you could settle for that and we'll just call it a day.
Prior to meeting with GLaDOS face to face, the game has already prepared you for this final test. The rocket turret was introduced just before the boss battle, where you use it to fire at you through the portals to break glass windows. The infamous companion cube level also serves to explain to the player how to use the incinerator to destroy objects. It also allows you to get revenge for your companion cube's untimely death.
You euthanized your faithful companion cube more quickly than any test subject on record. Congratulations.
However, this boss fight went through several iterations with playtesters before settling on the version present in the game. The first iteration of the fight involved lasers, but they were extremely boring to dodge and really difficult to aim, so rockets were used instead. The second version of the boss fight was described as a high-intensity rocket battle with GLaDOS, but this felt more like a shooter game rather than a puzzle game. The final version experimented with chasing GLaDOS through a series of corridors, but the players would often get lost and confused, and it did not have good pacing. The result is that the boss fight included in the game was designed to be more true to a puzzle game. This allowed for the focus to be more on the dialogue of GLaDOS, with the excitement and dramatic impact coming from the neurotoxin time pressure, rather than an action sequel. Portal was an instant hit with players who fell in love with the scientific concepts and extraordinary dialogue. The physics used in the puzzles also meant that the game would be used in education to teach students and allow them to solve puzzles creatively. It's for this reason that Portal is considered one of the best puzzle games ever made.